Hello everyone, welcome back to Chenda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a ruffle bralette top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this top, I make for size small. But in this video, I also showing you how to make it bigger and how to measuring it on your body. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the bra cup. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 20, it is equal 3.5 inches length. And this is just a sample showing you how to make in the stitch. You guys just follow the description that I show on the screen. And after you got 20 chains, and this is how you measuring it on your bust. Place this foundation chains from the underneath of your underarm until it reach your nipple. And for you guys that want to make your bra cup more bigger, you can add more chains until it reach the middle part of your breast, which is the nipple. And after you got your desired length, next we are going to make the bokeh shape. But first, you have to continue add 3 more chains. And for this chain 3, we also count it as a stitch. And next, we are going to make the bokeh shape into the 4th chain. To make the bokeh shape, yarn over, insert the hook into the 4th chain. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through 2 loops. And yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. And now you have 2 stitches. Next, keep making the bokeh shape into every chain until you have 1 last chain. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 1 last chain, next we are going to make increase by make 3 double crochet into the same loop. After you got 3 double crochet in the same loop, then chain 1. After you have made 1 chain, then make 3 more double crochet into the same loop. And now you must have 6 stitches of the bokeh shape with chain 1. And next, we are going to make the bokeh shape into these stitches. Keep making the bokeh shape into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, like I said, for this chain 3, we also count it as a stitch, so you have to make the bokeh shape into that stitch. And this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 3. Turn your work. Skip one stitch that near chain 3, then start making the bokeh shape into the next stitch. Keep making the bokeh shape into every stitch until you reach the chain 1 space, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the stitch near chain 1 space, then we are going to increase into this chain 1 space by make 2 double crochet in the same loop. After you have made 2 double crochet, then chain 1, and then make 2 double crochet into the chain 1 space. And now you must have 4 double crochet with chain 1. Next, continue make double crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the second row looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2. It means that you are going to make the bokeh shape into each stitch until you reach the middle part of the bra cup, which is the chain 1 space, then make increase into that stitch, and then continue make the bokeh shape into each stitch until the end of the row. Keep repeating this until you reach row 8, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. As you can see, this bra cup looks curved at the V part. You just stretch it a little bit to give a nice and flat roll. And this is what the bra cup looks like after you reach row 8. You can try this bra cup on your bust by placing it underneath of your underarm until it reaches the middle part of your chest. And for you guys that make bigger size, you can add more rolls until it reaches the middle part of your chest. And for the length of my bra cup, it is equal 6.5 inches length. Like I said, it's measuring from the underneath of my underarm until the middle part of my chest. And next, we are going to make single crochet into this bottom edge. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is, then chain 1. And then we are going to make single crochet into the double crochet stitch. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep making 2 single crochet into each double crochet stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, we are going to continue make the back part of the top. To begin, for row 1, chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. Then turn your work and skip the stitch near chain 3. Then start working the double crochet into the next stitch. Keep making the double crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And for the next row, please keep repeating row 1 until you reach row 40. It is equal 13.5 inches length. It's the measurement of my back part. And for you guys that make bigger size, please add more rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 40. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For this back part, we're measuring it from the first underarm until you reach the second underarm. Remember that this double crochet stitch is stretching, so you don't have to make it really big or really fit with your body. It's okay if it's a little bit smaller than your body, because this stitch is stretching, so it will stretch and fit your body when you're wearing it. And next, for the second bra cup, please repeat the same thing like the first bra cup. And don't forget to make single crochet into this bottom edge. And then leave the yarn there, you don't have to cut it off. And next, we are going to continue connect this second bra cup into the back part of the top. To begin, turn the bra cup wrong side out. And then we are going to continue from where your last stitch is. And make slip stitch both parts together by continuing insert the hook into the corner stitch of the back part, which is the first loop. Then yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make single crochet both sides together. Insert the hook into both loops that we make slip stitch. Then yarn over and pull through both loops. And now you have two loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through two loops. Keep making single crochet both sides together into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then chain one and cut off the yarn. And this is what the wrong side looks like. Flip it back and this is what the right side looks like. And now we are done connecting the bra cup into the back part of the top. And this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to make single crochet around this edge of this top, and we also make the string for the front tie. To begin, I'm start working from the right side of the bra cup, and then we are going to attach the yarn into the second stitch from the middle part of the bra cup. Chain 1, then make single crochet into the same stitch with chain 1. You can use stitch marker to mark at this first single crochet stitch. And next, make single crochet into the next stitch, which is the stitch that near chain space. After you have made 2 single crochets, then continue at 90 chains. It is the length for the front tie. If you guys want it more longer, please add more chains. After you got 90 chains, next we are going to make slip stitch. To begin, skip 1 chain and make slip stitch into the second chain. To make slip stitch, continue insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Keep repeating this into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. Thank you. And after you reach the end of the row, and then we are going to continue my single crochet into every stitch of the bra cup. And continue mid single crochet into each stitch of the double crochet row until you reach the middle part of the second bra cup. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the middle part of the second cup, you have to skip this last stitch that needs chain 1 space. And then we are going to continue at 90 chains. It's the same number like the first string. And after you got 90 chains, then we are going to make slip stitch into every chain until the end of the row. And then we are going to continue make single crochet into each stitch of the bra cup and into each double crochet stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. And next, we are going to continue make slip stitch into the first stitch. After you have made a slip stitch, next, we are going to make the bottom ruffle for this top. To begin, for row 1, chain 3, turn your work. Then make a double crochet into the same stitch with chain 3. And next, we are going to make increase by make 2 double crochet into the same loop. Keep making 2 double crochet into each stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the second string. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you had 2 last stitches from the second string. And then we are going to skip these 2 last stitches. Next, for row 2 until row 6, chain 3, turn your work and make the double crochet into each stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 6. Next, we are going to make the lace edge for this ruffle top. Continue from where your last stitch is for row 7, chain 3. Turn your work. Then we are going to make the V stitch by make double crochet into the next stitch. After you have made a double crochet, then chain 2. After you got 2 chain, then make a double crochet into the same loop. And now you must have 2 double crochet in the same loop with chain 2. Then we are going to skip 2 stitches and make the V stitch into the 3rd stitch by make double crochet into the 3rd stitch. Then chain 2 and then make a double crochet into the same loop. And now you must have 2 double crochet in the same loop with chain 2. And next, please keep repeating this into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, and now you must have 3 last stitches. So we are going to skip 1 stitch and make a double crochet into the next 2 stitches. And next, for row 8, chain 3. Turn your work. Then we are going to make V stitch into the next double crochet stitch. And after you have made a V stitch, then skip this chain 2 space and we are going to make V stitch into this loop between the V stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then we are going to skip this last chain 2 space and make a double crochet into the next 2 stitches. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the ruffle of this top looks like. And for the next part, we are going to make the sleeves, which is the ruffle strap of this top. To begin, I'm start working from the left sleeve first. by count 14 stitches from where we have connected the cup. And then use stitch marker to mark at the 15th stitch. And next, for the back part, count 10 rows after the double crochet stitch and use stitch marker to mark at the 10th row. And this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to start working the strap from the front part of the top. Attach the yarn into the 3rd stitch from the stitch marker. Then chain 3. For chain 3, we also count as a stitch. And next, make a double crochet into the next 2 stitches. And now you must have 3 stitches. Next, for row 2, chain 3. Turn your work. Skip the stitch near chain 3 and making the double crochet into the next 2 stitches. And now you must have 3 stitches of the double crochet, include the chain 3 stitch. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 31. It is equal 13 inches length. It's the measurement of my strap. If you guys want your strap more longer, you can add more rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 31. And next, we are going to attach the strap into the back part of the top. To begin, flip the strap inside out. And then we are going to make slip stitch both sides together by continuing to insert the hook into the other side's loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Then we are going to make single crochet both sides together into the next 2 stitches. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what the right side looks like. Next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the ruffle sleeves. To begin, attach the yarn into the back strap. And then chain 1. And next, we are going to make single crochet into each stitch of the strap until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, then we are going to continue making single crochet into each stitch of the bra cup until you have 1 last stitch from the string. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 1 last stitch from the string, Then we are going to make slip stitch. And after you have made a slip stitch, and next for row 1 turn your work, then we are going to make a single crochet into the next 2 stitches, but we will keep the stitch into the back loop of the stitch only. We are not insert the hook into both loop, just pick the back loop of the stitch. After you have made 2 single crochet back loop only, then we are going to make half double crochet into the back loop only. To make half double crochet back loop only, yarn over, insert the hook into the back loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Keep making half double crochet back loop only into the next 2 stitches. And after you have made 3 half double crochet back loop only, next we are going to make the double crochet increase by make 2 double crochet in the same loop. Remember, we only working the stitch into the back loop. Keep increasing into every stitch until you have 6 last stitches, then I will meet you back again. And after you have 6 last stitches, then we are going to make 3 half double crochet back loop only. And after you have made 3 half double crochet back loop only, then make 2 single crochet back loop only. And after you have made 2 single crochet back loop only, then we are going to make slip stitch back loop only into the last stitch. And after you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row looks like. We want the end of the strap look curved and more smaller. And next, for row 2 until row 3, turn your work, make a slip stitch, and start from row 2, we work in the stitch into both loop. After you have made a slip stitch, then make 2 single crochet. And after you have made 2 single crochet, then make 3 half double crochet. After you have made 3 half double crochet, then continue make double crochet into each stitch until you have 6 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 6 last stitches, then make 3 half double crochet. And next, make 2 single crochet. And then make a slip stitch into the last stitch. Keep repeating this until you reach row 3. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 3. And next, we are going to make the V stitch. To begin for row 4, chain 1, turn your work, and make slip stitch. Then make 2 single crochet. And next, make a half double crochet. And then we are going to make V stitch until you have 4 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. And after you have 4 last stitches, then make a half double crochet. Then make 2 single crochet. And then make slip stitch into the last stitch. And this is what the sleeve looks like. And next, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use darning needle to weave in. And this is what the ruffle sleeves looks like. You can sew this ruffle edge into the strap. And next, we are going to make single crochet as the border around this strap. To begin, attach the yarn into the back part of the strap. Then chain 1, and next, make single crochet into each stitch that we're working the stitch into the back loop only. And we still have the front loop, so you have to make single crochet into that front loop until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Then chain one and cut off the yarn. And for the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the right sleeves. It's just a little bit different. So you have to count 15 stitches the same for the front part. And count 10 rows for the back part and use stitch marker to mark it. And then we are going to attach the yarn and making the strap. The difference is when we make the ruff for sleeves, for row 1, you have to work in the stitch into the front loop of the stitch only. And for row 2 until row 4, you just repeat the same thing like the left sleeve. Remember, for the right sleeve, we insert the hook into the front loop. And for the left sleeve, we insert the hook into the back loop. This is when we make the ruff for sleeve for row 1. And now your ruffle bralette top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.